talk. Let's have conversations in the dark.
World is okay, welcome everyone. Can you all hear me okay? Yeah. To introduce myself, those of you who don't know me, I'm Steve. I'm Darcy's father, father of the bride.
Watch movies that we've both already seen.
So what a wonderful day. I'm sure you've all been enjoying yourself. I'd like to welcome the Ball family, the Hazard family, and all of you today for coming along and sharing in such a wonderful day. On a slightly somber note, a few people that were a big part of Darcy's life growing up who can't be with us today, who I'm sure would have really enjoyed today, and a pleasure to see Nathan and Darcy taking such a big step.
I will never try to change you, change you. I will always want the same you, same you. Swear on everything I pray to, that I won't break your heart. I'll be there when you get lonely.
Nath, you're truly a top bloke. You're loyal and you would help anyone you care about. One of the things I've always respected is you've always been your own person. I always say what you think and believe in, regardless of the situation. You're honest, hardworking, and you deserve all the good things that come your way.
On Sunday mornings we sleep until noon. Well, I could sleep forever next to you.
So this is the bit she cringes about, a few bits about Darcy. No, joking really, an amazing young woman who's made her father and her mum very, very proud with her achievements as studies in history and latterly with her amazing cake designs.
I recall a conversation a few years back when Nath told me that one of the keys to him and Darcy getting along so well together is that they're always laughing. Now Darcy's got a good sense of humour and she is funny, but if we're honest, you would never describe Nathan as funny. I can only assume she's laughing at him and not with him.
I will never try to change you, change you. I will always want to say
you look amazing.
Darcy, you've somehow managed to change to turn the big caveman into a right soppy sod. I've never seen Nathan as happy as I have since he's been with you. That's no easy task, and I imagine living with him isn't even either. So thank you for taking one for the team.
And your love is all you owe me.
Only those who are closest to me would know this, but I used to be quite an angry young man. The future seemed dark and life seemed pointless, but then as much of a cliche as it sounds, I met Darcy. And then little did I know that swiping right on Tinder would change my life forever.
I will never try to change you, change you. I will always want the same you, same you. Swear on everything I pray to.
Little by little, she brought life into my life, and since we've met, I've never laughed so much or felt so much happiness. She's there to celebrate with me at my highs, and there to comfort me when I'm at my lows. You're the love of my life and my soulmate, and the simple fact you've chosen me to spend the rest of your life with is an honour I don't think I'll ever be deserving of. So would you all please raise your glass to my new wife, Mrs. Darcy Ball.
Mrs. Ball!
Life is so simple. A little boy, a little girl, laughing and loving, trying to figure out the world.
This is a special day for Nathan and Darcy, for today they've chosen to make a public commitment to each other through vows sincerely made and faithfully kept.
Nothing you say wouldn't interest me. All of your words are like poems to me. I would be honored if you would take me as I am. I want you to look right in my eyes.
Marriage means making a commitment to developing cooperation. It calls for honesty, patience, and sometimes humour. A good partner will be loving and caring, but above all, a best friend.
I want to see your face, want to fall with grace at the moment I die.
Over the past few years, the more time I've spent with them, the clearer it is to see what a great couple they are. They complement each other perfectly and make an incredible team. I think we can all just see how much they love each other. If I could offer one piece of advice, just accept, you'll never be right and you can't get the last word in.
Above you, and longer if I can.
How long I call upon these persons here present to witness that I, Nathan Alexander Ball, do take thee, Darcy Grace Hazard, to be my lawful wedded wife.
That I, Darcy Grace Hazard, do take thee, Nathan Alexander Ball, to be my lawful wedded husband.
Promise to love you, to honour and respect you, I will care for you.
Laugh with you when you're happy, comfort you when you're sad.
Whatever life may bring, I will always love you.
How long will I want you? As long as you want me to.
Darcy, I give you this ring.
Darcy, I give you this ring.
Nathan, I give you this ring.
Nathan, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of our love.
As a symbol of our love.
And as a lasting reminder.
And as a lasting reminder.
Of the vows we have made here today.
The vows we've made here today. Today.
How long will I give to you? As long as I live through you. However long you say.
Nathan and Darcy both made the declarations prescribed by law here in the presence of your witnesses and all of your guests. It therefore gives me the greatest pleasure to announce you are officially now husband and wife. I think you know. Can I please ask you to stand for one final duty? As we introduce you for the very first time to the new Mr. and Mrs. Bull.
Sometimes I feel like I throw my hands up in the air. I know I can count on you. Sometimes I feel like saying, Lord, I just don't care. But you've got the love I need to see me through. Sometimes it seems the going is just too rough. Everything's gone wrong, no matter what.
Now to Nathan, my son-in-law. There you go, I've got a son-in-law. Welcome to our family, Nathan. Clearly a man of impeccable taste. Please take good care of my baby. She's grown up a bit now. And all I would say to you both, you know, in life sometimes things can get a bit tough. Try not to take it personally, sleep on it. And nothing's permanent. So good luck in your life together. You got the love. 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 You got the love.
Thank you both for letting me be part of your day. And thank you, Nathan, for asking me to be your best man. It's been a privilege, and I hope I've done you proud. I'd like to wish you both all the happiness in the future together and look forward to watching your journey continue. Can everyone please raise a glass for Nathan and Darcy, the new Mr. and Mrs. Bob.
There are some little pink bottles on your tables, and it wouldn't be my wedding day without a couple of shots. It's tequila rosé, which is basically like an adult strawberry milkshake, if you haven't had it before. So I would love it if you would join me in taking a shot now we've tied the knot. Cheers.